say good morning, but no, it's noon, and I'm headed, I think I'm going to go to this TJ Maxx over here, and just look around. I literally, the reason for the shopping trip is I want to get, maybe, I was going to go to Walmart, but then it then evolved to TJ Maxx because I want to get maybe pillows for my living room. That's beside the point. The original shopping trip today was going to be to Walmart because I want to get a bowl and a plate and like one set of silverware to have at work. That's mine. I use paper plates often if my Tupperware doesn't like hold what I'm eating once it's like prepared. Y'all know I do a lot of things that are deconstructed. So once I put it all together, sometimes you just like want a plate. And I just feel like it's so wasteful to use so many paper plates, like a week if I use 5. Like that's a lot at work. Plus breakfast. So really I'm using 10 a day like that, or 10 a day, 10 a week. It just seems excessive. And why not just have my own stuff that I can wash, my own like dishes. Sorry, the sun is, that's just how it is. I don't think I can fix it until we move. But yeah, so I think I'm gonna go just like get my own stuff. And it'll also be prettier on Instagram because right now those paper plates are not the cutest photos I've ever posted. But today, this is as good as it got today, okay? You know, you have those mornings and you're just like, I can't be bothered to do anything. That's how I was today. Like, literally couldn't be bothered to get ready. So, I obviously did my normal makeup, but this is a ponytail. I don't think I'm wearing, I'm not even wearing jewelry today. I'm just wearing the rings and that is it. I am, it's so funny. I never wore rings growing up. I hated them. And now I'm obsessed. I have a 4th that I used to wear constantly, but I replaced it with this one, this middle one. This is a $4.99 ring stack from World Market. I mentioned it in another video, but I didn't tell y'all where it was from. It's from World Market. This one I got on our Fredericksburg trip, and then this one I got in Denver, Colorado. I kind of have a tradition where I get rings on vacations. And like trips that I want to remember and stuff. So I had one and I talked about losing it in a video several months ago. I think that it's somewhere in my house. I'm like praying that when I move, I'm going to find the ring. I'm like really still heartbroken over it. But I got that ring on my sorority exec retreat, which is basically exec is the top 8 officers for that calendar. Ours was calendar year, so January through December. I was social in my sorority, so I did the party planning, and it was so fun. And you go on a retreat in January with the 8 of you just to get to know each other more. And it was really fun, and I got this ring from a vendor on the side of the road, handmade, had a little turquoise gem. It was inexpensive but beautiful. Never, you know, it was full sterling silver. It was so beautiful. Wore it all the time. I lost weight, and it fell off because it was so loose. I could shake my hand once and it would go flying. And I don't know why I kept wearing it. I should have taken it off and I didn't. And I learned my lesson because now it's gone. And I'm hoping that someday I will find it or go back to replace it because I seriously loved it that much. But, anyways, so I got 2 when I was in Colorado in February. This is one of them, just kind of overlap. I don't know if y'all can see that with the sun, but looks like that. And then it's kind of sideways, but it's like this. There we go. And then I have another one that sort of looks like a thumb ring. It's sort of a bigger band. You'll see it in my older videos, but I took that one off because it was getting a little big. And I even got this one and that one resized. What are you doing? Oh my God, literally yield to ramp. And he's like speeding and then wondering what I'm doing. And I'm like, well, I'm not going to get hit. So I literally hate people. So yeah, it kind of looks like a thumb ring. And I wore it on my thumb, so that makes sense. Maybe it is a thumb ring, but really cute. It was just too big. Even after I got it resized a little bit. So I don't wear that one anymore. But then I got this little hammered silver band, this little one right here. in Fredericksburg. It was like $25, sterling silver, super pretty. And then this little stack was just $4.99 from World Market. And this one does turn my finger a little bit green. It doesn't anymore, but it did the first. I think whatever turns it green has like rubbed off, you know, but I love it. I think it's really pretty and pretty enough that I would like repurchase if for some reason I needed to. So yeah, that's my little ring story. But headed to TJ Maxx. I actually don't 100% know where it's at because I usually go to a different Home Goods, but I will talk to you guys here in a little bit, especially if I find something. There's actually a Walmart right here that I didn't know was here, so I could run in there and get the silverware if I need to. So, anyways, talk to you guys in a little bit. Loving me was all you tried when you were around. I've been told too many times now. Yeah, loving me was all you tried when you were around. I've been told too many times now. But somewhere I'll go run and hide, looking for a new start. Yeah, somewhere I'll go run and hide, looking for a new start, for a new start. So I'm home from work. It's 5:45. I've been just kind of cleaning around the house, getting some laundry done, getting ready to leave on vacation on Friday. Sorry if the music in the background is loud. I'm playing Amanda Lewis's Clean With Me video. I seriously love her. I'll put a card right here and link her down below. Love her so much. She motivates me a lot. But I'm going to attempt some breakfast bars. Literally just making this up. This could be a complete fail. So stick with me, but I thought I'd show you, and if it's a total fail, you probably won't ever see this. So these are the ingredients that I used: some old-fashioned oats, some PB2, some pancake or waffle mix. Make sure you buy the kind that says just add water, otherwise you'll have to add in the calories for the eggs or the oil or whatever it calls for. And then some Lily's dark chocolate chips. You could definitely do berries, blueberries, or anything like that to put in this as well. I'm sure none of y'all are surprised to know that I forgot to hit start on the phone to record what I did, but I'm going to post a picture of my app, and you'll be able to see the exact amounts of everything that I used. You can just take a screenshot of the video if you want to make this. I will say it turned out good. I didn't use as much water as the pancake mix called for, and I definitely should have. I was trying to make them not puff up as much and be thicker, so I liked this consistency. But once it baked, it was a little bit dry. So I would pretty much match the pancake to water ratio exactly next time. But it was really good. My boyfriend really liked them. It definitely needs tweaking. This is by far not the best recipe that I've ever made or the best recipe that you're going to find. But if you're like me and you like to just do some experiments, maybe take this as a guide and then kind of do your own thing and figure it out yourself. But overall, it was good. And I'm excited to kind of experiment with this a little bit more. Oh, and I did bake them at 350 for 20 to 25 minutes. Okay, this is probably the least appetizing meal that I've ever shown, but whatever. It's delicious. So I have 6 ounces, it's really like 6.5, let me live, of the Tyson's chicken. It's like the frozen garlic one. So delicious. I'll post a picture of the packages. And then this is the Bob Evans potatoes. Honestly, they don't really taste like anything. I feel like they don't have a seasoning. So I added a little bit of salt and some nutritional yeast, which is what that yellow stuff is, and a little bit of Italian seasoning on top of that. I have never used nutritional yeast, but I have to say I am a fan. It's kind of like cheesy. I really like it. And then as you can see, I've already dug into my chicken. This is just the Bolthouse Farms Ranch. And I have a sparkling water. Someone gave me these orange ones because they bought them for their husband and he didn't like them. And they gave them to me. And I actually really like the orange. I would have never picked this like flavor myself. Ignore my manicure, gah. But I actually am a huge fan, so big fan of the orange. But this is dinner. I've got laundry going. Let me just flip you around. Looking for a new start. Okay, so I'm about to eat dinner. I've got laundry going. Well, it just finished, but I'm gonna wait until I finish eating before I move it to the dryer. I've done all the dishes. I need to wipe down the counters and then put away the stuff that I had to hand wash. I'm gonna run the dishwasher. There's only a few things in the top rack, but, well, the top rack's full, but there's nothing in the bottom. I'm gonna run it anyways. And get that done, so I'm ready to leave town. I'll show y'all the photo that I hung up, or like the canvas thing that I got at TJ Maxx. It looks so good. I'm such a fan. I need to move that table that's below it, but I seriously love it. But yeah, just kind of getting ready once this laundry is done. I really only had to do one load, and that's everything that I could need, plus all of my like work jeans and stuff for next week, so, or whatever week I come back to work. So it's been a really productive afternoon, which is surprising because I felt like I was falling asleep this afternoon. Like on the way home, I was like, I'm gonna take a nap. But I got home, I turned on YouTube, I started watching Amanda Lewis, who I love, and her videos were on a playlist for a while. And she just gave me motivation. I got all the stuff pretty much done, or at least like almost done, that I needed to do. And now all I have to do is tidy up the kitchen, like put those things away, wipe down the counters, and pack. And that's it, I'm done for the night. So that's exciting. I also made the breakfast bars for Morgan, but I haven't tried them yet. And I didn't have the phone recording for literally the entire recipe. So if they turn out good, I'll put the recipe for you down below. And I'll incorporate them into a video. If they're really good, I'll probably make them for him again because they're only 125 calories per piece and they're pretty good sized pieces. So I feel like hopefully it turns out good. The batter tasted really good. So I have high hopes, but that's enough of me. I'm going to get to eating and I'll talk to you guys probably one more time before I go to sleep. And then here's the little man. Hi, honey. Say hello. He's being such a cutie today. Aren't you? Yeah. Okay, y'all, so here is the pancake bake. I just used a regular, I think it's like a 9x9. Yeah, I haven't washed it yet. 9x9 inch pan. And I brought it out just because I wanted it to cool a little bit before I cut it. But it's nice and cool now, so I'm about to cut it into 9 squares. Just wanted to show you guys what it looks like. I'm going to take like a little sliver and see how it tastes, but I have really, really high hopes. So we shall see. Okay, story of my life. I forgot to hit record while I was cutting it, so there won't be any footage of that. Not that that's interesting, but sometimes those little like video features are good. But I just cut myself a little sliver off a big piece. So it's got chocolate chip, oats, some PB2, and some pancake batter. The chocolate chip fell out of that piece. So we're gonna try this piece. So, the verdict. Oh, what is this leaning on? There we go. Flavor's great. Not overly peanut butter, which I'm a little bit surprised by because I felt like when I tasted it, I was like, oh, did I put too much PB2? It's good, but it's dry. I did do less water than the pancake mix called for because I wanted it to be like a bar texture. It's still kind of a pancake texture. It just is a drier pancake. Definitely not the worst thing I've ever had. That's for sure. I actually kind of like them. Okay, so this is the piece that I just got from TJ Maxx. This table, I'm doing laundry, so my like laundry bin is right there. This whole table right here, I'm gonna take out to my parents' house, I think, so that won't be there, and I'll probably move this a little bit lower, but I really like it. You can see my vacuum.
I really, really like this. You can see my my chairs are a little bit shiny. They're like a shiny, like a beige color. It looks good with my mirror. It looks great with the accent wall because all the other walls are white, except for obviously that one in the reflection. But I'm a fan. It's just like a simple little piece, and it replaced this gather sign, and I am a huge fan. So anyways, I've got to get to moving the laundry over. I need to put my Cricut away, just kind of get the house tidy and start packing.
So that is all that you'll hear from me today. Thank you so much for watching this What I Ate in a Day video. I will put the recipe for the bars down below. I will show you whatever my total was for the day. It's going to be somewhere like 1450, probably close to 1450 or 1460 calories, which is A-okay with me. I'm feeling good about it. I definitely don't feel like I overate or I'm super bloated. I had a huge dinner though, I will say. It was like a big dinner. But I feel good. I was really, really hungry today. So I don't mind using a little bit more calories on days where I'm super hungry because I'm usually closer to the 1300 mark. And I feel like for my weeks, it kind of balances out in the end. So that's all for me. Thank you guys for watching. Give this video a thumbs up if you like What I Ate in a Day videos. Comment down below if you'd like to chat with me. Subscribe if you want to. And I will see y'all in my next video. Bye.
Loving me was all you tried when you were around. I've been told too many times now. Yeah, loving me was all you tried when you were around. I've been told too many times now. But somewhere I'll go run and hide, looking for a new start. Yeah, somewhere